Hello, here I have two old vases that are very, very old, as you can see, and because I don't want to throw them away, I just want to reuse them. So the way that I was thinking is to create a mosaic on those two, because I don't like the shape only of this one or the shape only of this one. I came with the idea that I will combine them, and now I like the shape. So for this reason, I'm going just to create a mosaic on the big one and a little bit mosaic just here to cover and give it the feeling that it's one piece. Now here I've started already on this small one. I've started the mosaic, and from broken dishes and from cups, I saved this part and I just attach it to the piece here. So here I will just continue to make the mosaic all the way around, and at the end it's going to look like the one that I have here already. So this is the piece that I finished already. So as you can see, it's very nice. I like it very much, and it's going to just look very nice on the sides here of my fountain. Now for this part, because it's detached, I just use the mosaic, as I said, only on the top side. So I went like all the way around, of course, and after that I'm going to just after I will finish the other side, of course, with mosaic, I'm going to just use the grout on top of the mosaic. I will try to go for a Tuscany color, like a brick color, because I like it very much. And for that, I will show you how you can grout this piece. And of course, after that, I'm going to use a sealer, because are going to be kept outside in a winter time. And I'm living in Canada and it's a very harsh winter in our region. So I will be sure that they will not get damaged over the winter. So I will show you exactly what you need to do. So for me, it was a very good way to use broken dishes and to enjoy, of course, by making those two pieces. Here I prepared the grout. It's a white grout, and the mixture needs to have this consistency, like thick yogurt or peanut butter. And I want to change the color. I don't like the white on my project, so I wish to get like a Tuscany color, kind of like this nice color that has like Italian flavor, kind of reminding me about our trip to Italy. And for that, I'm going to change the color, and I'm using those normal colors, like craft colors, very inexpensive. And I'm going to change with red and yellow, and I will mix as long as I will get the desired color. So you have to just do it little by little, and when you think that it's enough, then you can stop and you don't need to add more colors. So here I'm just going to mix it a little bit, and probably a little bit more I need that, because it's a big quantity. The containers are quite big, so I need a big quantity of the grout. So after I will use the grout on the pieces here, as you can see, I finished the second one. I'm going to just let dry the grout a little bit, and when the haze comes, I'm going just to wipe up with a sponge, wet sponge, and clean it with a dry cloth. So this is kind of the color that is okay for me. I don't want it too dark to be, because I want to see the tiles very well. So here I have the one that I'm going to apply. So I have here, like as I said, few pieces. I'm going to remove one, make it easier for me to just use the grout. And I'm just using a piece of plastic, it's very handy, and just apply the grout on the mosaic. You need this consistency for the grout, because as you can notice, goes very well between the cracks and covers all the holes that you have or cracks between the pieces. So after I will finish to complete the whole piece with the grout, as I said, I'm going to let it dry. When the haze forms at the top of it, it means that it's dry and I can start to clean it. I'm using a wet sponge and a dry cloth, and that is pretty much the entire process. I will finish it here and I will get back to you. I finished to cover with grout entirely, both containers. Now I will let them dry. As you can notice here, it's going to form a haze. And when this one forms, it means that you can start and clean it. As I said, I'm using a sponge, a wet sponge, and a little bit water, of course. And after I will clean all everywhere the mosaic, I will just finish it by shining it with a dry cloth. So that is the procedure here. I will finish after that with a sealer on top of it. Now, I want those containers to have a foot each, so I'm going to create the foot for the container. So here I have another two small containers, and I have used the cement, two parts sand, one part cement. It's a very runny mixture, and I just pour the cement here between the two pieces of those containers. So when you remove the pieces here, you'll get the cement container. It's going to be the foot for my project. So here I will just clean it from the sand that I used, so the bottom of it, and I will just put one of those large containers on top of it. And that is going to make even taller the entire piece. So I will just finish this foot as well with the same grout color that I use for the containers. So everything comes together. When I will finish, I will get back to you to show you the final look for the project. So here is the final look of my project with the large parts. And as you can see, the project could be a very nice one. I like very much the way that they look now. So they have a good height for the place that they are now. And you can see the design all the way around for the mosaic. And they fit very well for this space. It's a large wall for me here that I wanted just to cover with some more color, but in the same time I didn't want to damage the wall or to put something on the wall, just against of it, like those two parts. And as you know, I got those ones from the ones that are, they were very old, no more use for them the way that they were. So I just try to combine two by two. I have created a foot with the cement as I showed, and I just use any kinds of colors that they will go very well with the place for me here. And for the project that I've created here, I spent around 4 or 5 days because I needed the cement to just get hard enough for the pads, like 24-48 hours I waited for the pads to dry out the cement. And the mosaic, the rest of the days I was working, and I just grouted and I changed the color as I showed you for this ceramic kind of Tuscany pottery color that I love it very much. And they are matching the fountain as well, so I'm pretty happy with the entire project. Definitely brings me a lot of joy watching them, and of course together it's a very nice ensemble. I'm hoping that was an inspiration as always for you, this project. Check my other topics on my channel. Glad to give you, I'm willing to give you any information that you're looking for regarding the projects. I'm hoping that you enjoyed as well with my story regarding my old pots. Thank you so much for watching. I wish you a very good day. Goodbye.